Hello students, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to give you 8 latest defense updates. Number 1, Zorawar light tank to get 105mm cannon. In a recent interview, Dr. Samir B. Kaman, chairman of DRDO, announced significant advancement in the development of the DRDO LNT Zorawar light tank. He confirmed that the tank will feature a locally developed 105 cannon, replacing the Cockerel 105mm high-pressure cannon that was showcased in the prototype. This move underscores India's push for indigenization in its defense projects. Next, combat infantry vehicle ready. A significant milestone has been achieved in India's indigenous defense manufacturing as the DRDO and L&T developed composite combat infantry vehicle, that is CCIV, has completed its internal trials. This cutting-edge armored vehicle is now poised to compete for the Indian Army's highly anticipated futuristic infantry combat vehicle contract. The CCIV stands out for its impressive weight-to-power ratio. Despite being equipped with a formidable arsenal, including a 30mm automatic cannon, a coaxial machine gun, and a remotely operated weapons station with a 12.7mm machine gun, the vehicle maintains a remarkable low weight of under 18 tons. Next, indigenization push for VAP 8x8. The director of the Vehicles Research and Development Establishment recently announced significant advancement in the development of the VAP 8x8 amphibious wheeled armored vehicle. Rao highlighted the VRDE is aiming to increase the indigenous content of the VAP to over 80% in its next iteration, with plans to further raise this to 85% to 90% within the next 18 months, just before the vehicle enters full-scale production. Next, Navy to fast-track submarine induction. The Indian Navy welcomed a significant addition to its fleet on August 29th with the induction of the INS Arighat. This 6,000-ton submarine, constructed at the Indian Navy's Shipbuilding Center in Visakhapatnam, represents a major milestone in India's indigenous submarine development program. Next, creation of a private army ruled out. Former Air Chief Marshal Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhaduria has categorically ruled out the possibility of creating a private army in India, emphasizing that the nation already possesses a professional and capable military force. Speaking in an interview with Bharat Tak, Bhaduria responded to questions about whether India might consider employing private military groups like Russia's Wagner Group, which has been used in recent conflicts such as the ongoing war in Ukraine. Next, VLSRSAM truck mounted system. The DRDO has successfully fabricated an 8x2 truck mounted systems for the vertical launch short range surface to air missile. Initially designed for the Indian Navy, the VLSRSAM system is now being adapted for the use by the Indian Air Force. The VLSRSAM is a low-level quick reaction surface-to-air missile system capable of neutralizing a wide range of aerial threats, including aircraft, helicopter, unmanned aerial vehicles, drones, and precision-guided munitions. Next, Centrum Electronics Secure DRDO Order. Centrum Electronics Limited, a leading player in electronic system design and manufacturing, has announced that it has received a significant order from the DRDO valued at Rs. 109.58 crore The order pertains to the supply of inter-satellite link and other payload systems, which are critical components for satellite communication and data transmission. Next. Approval to be taken for mega warship battle tank projects. Amid the ongoing standoff with China, the Defense Ministry is set to undertake major projects, including the construction of 7 advanced frigates for the Indian Navy and the Indian Army's proposal to replace its T-72 tanks with modern future-ready combat vehicles. The meeting chaired by Defense Minister Rajnath Singh is scheduled for Tuesday at South Block and will be attended by top officials, including the Chief of Defense Staff, the three service chiefs, the Defense Secretary, and other relevant officials. Thank you.